Hello guys, welcome back to this YouTube video. In today's video, I am going to explain to you about another method in the language learning. In this case, I am going to be talking about the community language learning. As you can see in the picture, this method was created by Charles Curran, and also, you can see a picture of him in the presentation, and he was a psychologist, better known as the creator of the community language learning. So let's begin with the presentation about this method. So as you can see in the picture, the community language learning is also known as the CLL. These are the abbreviation in English, the community language learning. So as you can see in the picture, this is a classroom with a teacher and the students working with this method, which is the community language learning. And now let's see the introduction to this method. This method advises teachers to consider their students as a whole person. What does it mean, a whole person? Well, a whole person learning means the teachers consider not only their students' intellect, but also they have some understanding of the relationship among the students' feelings, physical reaction, sensitive protection reactions, and desire to learn. So in this case, the teacher considers a student as a whole person. They take into account their feelings, the physical reactions, and he or her desire to learn during this process. And according to Curran, 1997, adults often feel threatened by a new learning situation, and he believed that a way to deal with the fears of students is for teachers to become a language counselors. So in this method, the kid word is counselors. The teacher is a counselor for the students, so they are going to guide the students in the learning process. They are going to be with them. They are going to help them in the, as I said, in the learning process. But he is going to be a counselor, and the students also need to feel independent during the process. Yes, they are going to be needing the teacher, but like the other method, not all the time. So let's continue with the presentation. And as you can see in this method, the communication is the key. The communication is going to be everything for the students to learn so much better the target language. So in this case, the students are going to be independent. They need to be active in their process in order to learn, and they need to have a communication between students and teacher. And also the communication is going to be a fundamental part with another student. So there's need to be a communication in the classroom. And now we are going to see the techniques of the community language learning method. So now we are going to start with the techniques that this method has. And the number one is recording a student's conversation. This is the first technique that this method implements. So what does it mean, the recording a student conversation? Well, during this technique, the students record conversations in the target language. A teacher might be using a digital voice recording device, such as an MP3 player, a cell phone, or a computer. Nowadays, we have a lot of technological devices that can be useful in order to record a student's conversation. So in this case, what does it mean, this technique? Okay, and during this technique, the teacher is going to record the student's conversation. The students are going to say chunks in the target language. They are going to say a phrase, a word, and in their native language. So in this case, I'm going to give you an example. In this case, I speak Spanish and English as well. So I say, the teacher is going to ask me what word or what phrase I want to express to the classroom. So I say, buenos dias. And the teacher translates this phrase into the target language. And then the teacher says, good morning. So, and I have to listen to the teacher's pronunciation in the target language. And I have to repeat this phrase, good morning. So, in this moment, the teacher is going to record using a tape recorder. So he's going to record my voice while I'm saying good morning. So he's going to record this phrase as well as the other students, and he's going to be asking each one or some students in order to say some phrases that they want to learn in the target language. So he's going to say, another student's going to say, for example, buenas noches. And the teacher is going to translate this word into the target language, and he's going to say good night or good evening, depending on the situation. So he's going to record our voices, and then he's going to play the video, or in this case, he's going to play the tape recorder once again when he or she has all the voices of the students recorded and the audio. So this is basically what recording a student conversation is. This is what this first technique involved. And now let's continue with another technique. In this case, now we are going to see the transcription. And this is the second technique. And this has a close relationship with the first one, because in this technique, the teacher transcribes the student's recorder conversation. So during this technique, the teacher is going to transcribe all the students' recorder of phrases, words, sentences in the target language conversation. So as you can see in the picture, there is a teacher who is writing on the board, and he is writing sentences in the target language. In this case, it is the English language. So in this case, the teacher is in charge of writing on the board, or even he can use paper, or he can use copies of the translation, in this case of the recorded conversation. So in this case, the teacher is going to transcribe every single recording, so the students can perceive, can see, and also they are going to have the opportunity to write in their notebook the translation the teacher is writing on the board. So the teacher is going to write every single phrase, every single word on the board, and he's going to show you to the student what they already said in the recording. So the student can see the writing part of the words that they said before. So this is basically what transcription is. And students, like I said before, they are going to have the time in order to write the words or phrases in their notebook. So they can have time in order to study these new words and this new vocabulary so much better. And also the teacher is going to use this transcription in order to do other activities in the future classes or even later on in the class. So he's going to use this vocabulary with the students in order for them to retain the information and apply this information into games and into another activity that can be really useful for the students. So this is basically what transcription technique is. And like I said before, the first one and the second one, they have a close relationship, because in the first one, we have to record our voices in the target language. And in the second one, in the transcription technique, the teacher needs to write every single word that we said on the on the tape recorder so we can see the information in a new vocabulary in words. And now let's continue with the technique number three. And this is called the reflection on experience. During this technique, the students are going to provide feedback about the class. So as you can see, a student's feedback about the class, it is basically what it means, reflection on experience. The teacher understands them and shows that he has listened carefully by giving an appropriate understanding response to what the student has said. So during this technique, the student has this pace in order to tell the teacher how they feel. How they feel learning during this process. So during this space, the teacher is going to ask every single student to give a feedback about the class. The teacher is going to ask the students about, how do you feel during this process? Are you learning? Do you feel comfortable? And in these questions, the students are going to have the opportunity to say something about the class. One important thing about this technique is that the feedback is going to be given at the end of each lesson. So at the end of every single class, the students are going to have the opportunity to give to the teacher a feedback about the class. So like I was saying before, the teacher is going to ask, how do you feel about learning with this method? Do you feel that you are learning? Do you feel that you are going to learn? So the students are going to respond to these questions, and they can say, for example, a student can say, teacher, I feel like I am not learning. Another response, it can be, I feel like I have learned during this process. I think that we can change these, or even I feel comfortable with the activities that we are implementing during the class. So the teacher is going to receive every single response the students said in a positive way, in order to give a better environment in the next classes. So this is basically what reflection on experience is. And also the teacher during this technique is going to promise to the students that don't worry about the process, if they don't have to worry about not learning in the first class, because they are going to have so much more time in order to retain the information, in order to study so much more, in order to improve every single class. So this is basically this technique. What this technique is, and also what this technique involved. And now let's continue with another technique, which is called the reflective listening. What is the reflective listening? So as you can see in the presentation, the students relax and listen to their own voices speaking in the target language on the recording. And at this point, a student listens to their own voices. So during this technique, students are going to listen, are going to reflect on their pronunciation, on their voice, on the recording. So in this moment, the teacher is going to use once again the tape recorder, because during the implementation of this technique, the teacher needs to provide to the students the recorded voices, because the students are going to listen to their voices, are going to reflect on their pronunciation in order to improve their speaking skill so much more in the next classes, so, or even in the next activity. So during this moment, students are going to be listening to their own voices in the recording in order to retain the information that they said, in order to guess the meaning, the context of the words that they are saying. So they need to reflect on listening in order to improve in the following situation. So this is what reflecting listening is. Also, during this technique, if a teacher doesn't have a tape recording of the students' voices, so the teacher can use their own his or her own voice in order to tell students words, phrases, a new vocabulary. So a student can listen to the teacher's voice in order to retain the information and also to practice by themselves the words and the new vocabulary. So this is what reflecting listening is. And now let's continue with another technique, which is called the human computer. So you may be wondering, a human computer, what is it? Don't think about a computer, a human computer. No, let's imagine about a teacher repeating, helping a student with their pronunciation. That's why we say a computer, because in this case, the student is going to be in charge of directing or even to manage the human computer. In this case, the human computer, it is the teacher. So the student is going to work with the teacher in order to speak, in order to know the pronunciation of a word or a phrase or a new sentence. It can be also. So what does it mean, human computer? And as you can see in the presentation, don't correct, just repeat. It is through the teacher's constant manner of repeating the word or phrase clearly that the student self-corrects as she tries to imitate the teacher's model. So as I was saying before, in this case, the human computer is going to be the teacher, and the teacher is going to be in charge of teaching to the students the pronunciation of words. So it is through this technique that students have the opportunity to correct their mistake. So in this case, the students correct their mistake by repeating the words 1, 2, 3 as many times as they want. So in this case, if the students want to say, wants to repeat or wants to know the pronunciation of a word, so he's going to say, he's going to tell to the teacher the word that he wants to pronounce. So the teacher comes to the student and repeat the word as much time as she or he can, so the students can listen to the teacher's voice, and he's going to repeat the word until the pronunciation it is in a correct way. So during this technique, the students have the opportunity to self-correct by themselves, but as I said before, by using the teacher as a model, because the teacher is going to model their pronunciation or with speaking to the students. So in this case, if I don't know the pronunciation of a word, if I want to say it, Buenos dias, so the teacher is going to come to me and he's going to be repeating good morning, and I am going to be listening and I am going to be repeating by myself good morning until I have the correct pronunciation of this word, or in this case of this phrase. So this is basically what the human computer is and how it works. So this is basically this technique involves and how it is worked during the classes and during the learning process. And now let's continue with another technique, which is called the small group talks. So what does it mean, the small group? Okay, as you can see in the presentation, interactions by group works, and there are a lot of different activities that could take place with the students working in the small groups. So during this technique, the students have the opportunity to create communities with their classmates. So the teacher uses this technique in order to Develop a sense of community, of trust, of security, and also confidence among students. So during this time, students have the opportunity to get to know each other with another student, to help each other during the learning process, because they are going to be working alongside with another one and also with the teacher, and the teacher is going to be around each group in order to help them with some problems that they can have. So this is basically what small group tasks is. And also, using this technique, the teachers want their students to develop a strong sense of communication, like I was saying before. And this method in the community language learning, the communication is the key. So students need to communicate, need to speak. Students have to speak each other in order to develop self-confidence, in order to speak so much better, and in order to get to know each other. And also, the teacher asks to the students in order to create new sentences, new words, new phrases, in order to tell these words to the rest of the classes, to the rest of the students, sorry. So the other students can learn from each single team in this case. So that like I was saying before, every single team is going to be helping each other, and also they are going to be learning by the other and also by the teacher. So this is the technique, and this is what involves. And now we are going to continue with another feature of this method. We already finished discussing the techniques of this method, and I'm going to give you like a little review. So the techniques of this method are the students' recurrent conversation, the transcription, reflecting on experience, reflecting listening, and also we have the human computer, and the last one it was the small group tasks. So these were the techniques that this method has, and how every single teacher worked with this technique in the learning process. So now we are going to continue with another experience during this method, and it is called the SWOT. And what does it mean, SWOT? So Curran said that there are six elements that are fundamental in order to teach in the community language learning process. So what does it mean, SWOT? The letter S is for security. The letter A is for attention. The other letter, A, is for aggression. The letter R is for attention. The letter R also is for reflection. And the last one, the letter D, is for discrimination. So these are the six words, in this case, the six elements that contain the community language learning process or method, I can say. So Curran said that these are the non-verbal communication. So as you can see in the picture, and the information also, it says some ideas about successful learning in CLL contain a few psychological factors. And I already said the factor, which are security, attention, aggression, retention, reflection, and discrimination. So these are grouped under an acronym called SWOT. So this is, and now we are going to learn so much more about each one, about each factor. And the first one, it is security. The first word, the letter S, it goes for security. What does it mean, security, in the learning process? So security, in order to make a student feel self-confident and secure enough to attend the class successfully, a student's relation with another person in the class can affect in this factor. So as I was saying before, the students need to feel confident about the learning process. They need to develop a strong sense of security also, so they can be successful in the classes. So the teacher is in charge of develop the security in their students. They can feel secure, they can have trust in the teacher and also around the other classmates. So the teacher needs to provide an environment in which students can feel secure, can feel free in order to speak, in order to express themselves, what they want to say, what they feel, what they want to learn, because we need to remember that students, during this method, we consider students as our client, because in this method, the teacher needs to keep the client happy as much as she or he can. So we need to encourage our students in order to keep on going in the process of learning. We need to tell our students that they are able to do anything they want. They can learn as much as they can. So in this way, we are going to develop security and confidence in our students in order to be successful at the end of the class. So as you can see, in this method, it doesn't exist the word I can't, because we can't. I can't, you can't, we all can't. We all can learn a new language, and we all can learn as much things as we want. So we need to improve this, we need to develop this security in the classroom during this process of learning. And the next one, it is attention and aggression. What does it mean, attention in the learning process, or even in this community language learning process? So aggression in this case, it can be identified as a child trying to explain to his or her parents about what she or he has learned in the school. This is a way to show his or her power by using the knowledge as a tool. This is also named self-assertion. So aggression in this case is the students telling to their parents how I feel about learning in this process, how much I have learned in the classroom, how I feel by working with this method in the classroom. So this is the power that we have as a student to tell our parents or friends or family how much we are learning. If I am learning, well, I am going to tell to my parents, look, I learned this new word in the class. I learned how to say buenos dias. I learned how to say hola. I learned how to say adios. And in this case, we are going to translate goodbye, good morning, hello. So this is basically what aggression is. So as the students develop a sense of security and self-confidence, they won't feel fear, or they won't feel like they can't do anything. They are going to be expressing by themselves, and they are going to be showing to the rest of the world, in this case to their parents, what she or he has learned in the process. And this is what aggression is. And now, what is attention? Attention is learners need to be got involved in a successful learning period. And this is identified as attention inside. So in this case, we need to involve every single student in the learning process in order to be successful. So we need to involve each student. As I was saying before, we need to keep happy, and we need to assure students that they are going to be successful at the end of the class, that they are going to learn the target language, that they are going to be able to express themselves with the target language, and we need to take away the fear of every single student. And we need to take away also every single variety that the students has, because as learners, when we are learning a new language in this case, we have a lot of fears. We have barriers that we can do, of that we can learn the target language. So we need to keep a student's attention focused on the classroom. We need to focus on a student in order to tell a student that they can't, in order to feel motivated with the class, in order to feel that they are learning during the process. So the letters A, it goes for attention and aggression. And now let's continue with the next element. In this case, the letters R goes for attention and reflection. And what does it mean, retention? Well, let's take a look at the presentation, retention. If a learner retains the material after involving in learning process as whole person, it is internalized and becomes a part of a learner. So in this case, as much as the student perceives or sees information, the more he or she is going to retain the information, so much better. So during this element, or even implementing this factor in the classroom, we need to assure the student's retention of the information that we are providing to them. So in this case, a learner is going to retain the information as much as she or he can perceive materials. Also, that the teacher can use pictures. The teacher can use posters in order to keep the attention of every single student. And also, as the students are retaining the information, they are going to be reflecting about the new vocabulary and the new information the teacher is providing. So what does it mean, reflection? So students need a reflection period to learn the language properly. Teacher reads a text a few times and students listen to it repeatedly for reflections. Oh, in this case, related to reflection. So in this case, both words are have like a close meaning, because the students are going to retain the information, but also they need to reflect about the information, because it doesn't matter if we are retaining a new information, but we need to reflect on this information, because otherwise it is not going to be useful, because we are going we will forget the information in a short period of time. So and this is not what the teacher wants, because when we are teaching a new language, we want the students to retain the information and can use the vocabulary for a long time, or even for a whole life. So in this case, we need to keep the retention, and also we need to tell a student, or even that we need to improve this retention on every single student, and also students need to reflect on the information that they are learning. So in this case, the class is going to be successfully, and also students are going to learn so much better than the past, because they are going to be more focused on the new words and the new information, and they are learning, and of course the new language that they are trying to speak and learn. And finally, we have the letter D, and it goes for discrimination. What does it mean, discrimination? Well, discrimination, in this case, the students compare their voices with the teacher's voice in order to see the language form, also the differences clearly in the target language between two recordings. So this is basically like the technique that we already discussed, because during this process, students are going to compare their voices with the teacher voice in order to retain the pronunciation, in order to improve the pronunciation, and also in order to speak so much better, because they are going to be focused on the pronunciation, and they are going to They are going to try to speak at this as the teacher does in the recording audio. So during this case, as you can see in the picture, there are students listening to audios. In this case, it can be videos, sounds. So the teacher is free to use every single device that she or he wants to use, and also audios, videos, whatever she or he wants. So in this case, we are going to focus on the students to listen to our voice as teachers, and they're going to be repeating the information as much as she or he can or she or he want, because the student is free to do to listen as much time as she or he wants. So, and this is going to be useful in order to students to speak in a more fluent way in the target language. So this is basically what discrimination is. And also we are going to be helping a student, because if, let's imagine that I am the teacher and I am expressing a phrase like, hello students, good morning, welcome to this class. So students are going to listen to the up to my voice in the audio, and they are going to listen. Hello students, good morning, welcome to this classroom. And they are going to be repeating this audio as much times as they want, and they are going to be listening to my pronunciation, and they are going to be trying, and they will try to speak in this way as I did, because they are going to be focused on the pronunciation. So this is the discrimination factor or element in the community language learning process. So all of this information is really important during the process of learning, because all these techniques and factors, element, these six elements that the Kieran said, that the nonverbal education and involved during this community language process. So this is basically what they are and how they work. And finally, we have the features of the community language learning. And the number one is language effort communication and improvement of creative thinking. And also it focuses in sharing and interacting rather than grammar or sentence and form. Number three, a confidence must develop between a student and teacher. And the number four, teacher is a counselor in the class, like I was explaining you before. During this method, the teacher is a counselor in the class, because he's going to take a student in order to learn the target language, and he or she is going to be in charge of teachers to improve and remove the fear of threatening factors in the class. So these are some features of the community language learning that we already discussed in the previous presentations. And also we have the teacher and students, and the students and students interactions are seen and also important, like I was telling you before, because teacher also provided proper students with interaction. So communication and communities and interactions are a fundamental part during this process. As students are clients and depend on the teacher in early stage of classes, but however, on the other side, we have that in later stages, they will get more independent day by day. And finally, when teaching vocabulary in order to make the meaning clear, native language can be given to students with target language. An important fact, one interesting information during this process, it is that what we are teaching with the community language learning, we need to work alongside with the native language and the target language, because the students are going to, because we need to translate to the students the vocabulary that they want to learn, the vocabulary that they want to translate. So And as teachers, we are here in order to help our students to learn the target language so much better. And also, like I said, students are clients, and she or he is going to depend on us as teachers in early stages of classes. However, when they have a variety of words, when they can express them by themselves so much better, they are not going to be dependent on us like they used to did when they learning in the first process, on when they were learning the first words in the target language. So this was basically my presentation about the community language learning method. And thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you can have a better understanding on this method that is really, really important, and also it can be really useful as teachers, because we can implement this method in our classroom in order to help our students to learn the target language so much better. And remember that every single day we learn something new. We learn from our students, and our students learn from us. So we need to work together as a community in order to assure the education of every single student, and also to keep a happy environment, a cheerful environment, in which every single student and us a teacher as well, we can have a good learning process. So this learning and teaching a process. So this was my presentation. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I can't wait to see you next time in the next presentation and also in the next video. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time, and see you next time. Bye.